we've bought a super rare Mark 1 Astra GTE. There are as few as 8 on the road in the UK today, and our aim is to make that 9. But first, I've got to see if I can crank over this engine that's been sat unlubricated and unloved for the last 30 years.
Oh, yes. It's turning. I mean, that is such a relief. It tells you the components inside are moving up and down freely. Oh, and that gives me something to work with. Brilliant news.
With the engine turning over, we should be able to get it running again, but some components are bound to need repairing or replacing. So I've got to get the engine out and open it up to find out just what we need to do.
Well, there we go. With the engine and gearbox out, I'm going to separate the two of them and then strip them down and see what we got. Well, while the car's in the air, I'm going to have a good look around that as well.
So whilst Mike tackles our parts problem, I need to work out what 3 decades of being sat unused has done for the inside of our engine.
This is a great little engine, this, but it hasn't done anything, hasn't turned over for a long, long time. And in fact, I can already see some serious signs of corrosion. My worry, of course, is how bad that corrosion is on the inside and what damage it might have done to the components in there. And the only way to find that out is to strip it apart and have a look. Wow, blimey, that is horrible. That oil pickup is covered in, I mean, disgusting sludge. But I've never seen one looking like that before.
And as I dig deeper, things only get worse.
But it's in here where the problems are going to be. Look at that, the corrosion down the side of the bore. It's been sat for such a long period of time, it's just starting to eat away at the surface of that material. I've got to say, I think this block is going to have to go away to a machine shop and almost certainly be re-bored. Maybe not a massive surprise, but not the news I was hoping for.
And the problems don't end there. The pistons, main bearing shells, and big end bearing shells are all corroded and damaged and will also need to be replaced.
It may well point to the fact that this oil pickup has been clogged for a long time and the engine's actually run in that condition. Because actually, if we look at the crankshaft in the corresponding place at number 4, it's got some nasty score marks in it. So bad, in fact, that I'm pretty sure that's not going to polish out and will probably need re-grinding. So together with re-boring the block and the crankshaft and everything else, got a huge amount of work involved.
While the body and replacement bonnet are away having their paintwork touched up and detailed, I need to work out what to do with the engine. Hopefully, Mike's having more luck with the Astra owners community in his hunt for the spare parts. A few days later, I'm back at the garage and our engine is ready to be put back together. First, I'm putting the crankshaft main bearings into the block, followed by the now perfectly smooth crankshaft and new main bearing shells. Next, I'm tapping our new pistons, the only ones left in the country, very gently into place. Now the cylinder head and cam cover. And this 30-year-old engine that's now as good as new can be very gently put back where it belongs.
Elvis, my man!
I'm what?
Bearing gifts. How are we getting on?
Yeah, coming on really nicely, I have to say. Really looking forward to that. This, though, is that what I think it is?
It is your headliner.
Oh, nice.
Yes. Whoa. Be really careful with it. It's travelled a long way. It's come all the way from the Netherlands.
Has it?
This is the same material they used in the 1980s, so be careful with it.
All right. I might actually need a helping hand to get it in the car, because it could well be a two-man job, so I'll give you a shout when I'm ready.
No worries at all. And once we get this car finished, things like this, though, are going to make all the difference. And we can present it in front of, and you're going to like this, other Astra Mark 1 GTE owners.
You getting them all together?
I'm going to try and get them all together. Nice. Yeah, that'd be pretty cool, wouldn't it?
Yeah, that's wicked.
If you need me, give me a shout. I'll let me put that in.
Will do. Nice one, mate.
There are not many companies out there that produce period, authentic headliners like this, hence why it's come all the way from the Netherlands. Now, it has been made from a template of our old one, so it should fit perfectly, but the material's incredibly fragile, so one wrong move and I'm going to be in a whole world of trouble. Thankfully, Mike's not managed to glue himself to the car, and our headliner's now held in position, so I can crack on with getting the rest of it stuck in.
It's going okay, but I've got to say this material is tricky. Mike thought he had a tough job trying to find this stuff. He should try fitting it. Okay, we're almost there. With these last little bits stuck on, that is about it.
With the headliner fitted in place, I can reinstall the glass to keep it secure. Next, I'm very carefully installing the seats, which now look brand new thanks to a bit of deep cleaning, and then getting to work on the exterior trim.
With parts for this car being so rare and difficult to find, now that I've got some, I just hope they go together nicely without breaking or me finding out that I need a whole bunch more.
Our Mark 1 Astra GTE is all but finished, and luckily, all the remaining parts have gone on. So all I need to do now is add the cherry on top.
Right, there we go. That's the rear bumper now fitted with those brackets that Mike found me. And the other thing that he's got me are these, the stickers or decals that will turn our simple Astra into a proper GTE. And he's also got me some detailed information to ensure that I get them in exactly the right spot.
With the last door handle surround clipped into place, there's nothing more I need to do. So I'm saying that this car's done.
Yuck. Get in!
Wow! My man, seriously. What an utter transformation.
You haven't only made me happy, I think you've made the rest of the planet happy here.
I remember what it looked like when I got it. Yeah. It was just a shell, boxes of bits, blue bonnet, had a blue body kit, yellow wheels.
I know.
Now look at it, it looks like a proper state-of-the-art, back-in-the-day Mark 1 Astra GTE. I feel like I'm standing in a Vauxhall showroom.
It is amazing. I mean, I do remember what it was like. It was a massive jigsaw puzzle with a load of bits missing and no real picture to work from. But look how it's turned out.
Do you know the other thing we could be really pleased with? We've just put another Mark 1 Astra GTE on the road.
Yeah, we haven't we?
Not many people can say that.
That's right.
Thanks to Elvis's skill, ingenuity and hard work.
Oh, yes, it's turning. I mean, that is such a relief.
A classic bit of dealing from me.
I got it all for a bargain price, I couldn't believe it, really. £830.
And a touch of luck here and there.
You don't know me, but if I could leap across and give you a kiss, I would do.
This Astra has gone from second-hand jigsaw puzzle to work of art and added one more car to the tiny handful currently registered on UK roads. But how much has it set us back? I bought the car from Jason for £7,000. All the engine parts, that's pistons, main bearing shells, big end bearing shells and auxiliary pieces, cost £600. We've also changed the clutch, tyres and fluids at a cost of £450. The clips, rear axle and decals from Gareth were £830. The paintwork touch-ups and detailing were another £2,500. And finally, the headliner was £200. Giving us a rather large total of £11,580. It's a lot of dosh, but worth every penny to save an iconic bit of British motoring hot hatch history. And hopefully it will sell for a decent profit.
Click here to subscribe.